on behalf of the people of India and on my personal behalf, I welcome you all to this summit. In January 2013, while concluding the sixth summit, I had extended an invitation for today's event. Your response has been outstanding. I am glad to be here to welcome you. On this occasion, I express my gratitude to the all partners of this event. Both countries and organizations, these include Japan and Canada. Without that support, this event could not have come this far. I also welcome warmly and thank new partners like USA, UK, Netherlands, Australia, Singapore, and South Africa for joining this event. I particularly thank the Secretary General of the United Nations and the President of the World Bank for the presence. It shows their commitment towards progress and prosperity in emerging economies. Your partnership has enhanced the enterprising spirit of 60 million Gujaratis. It had boosted the morale of 1.2 billion Indians. This event is perhaps the biggest gathering on earth where a budding entrepreneurs has the opportunity to see the President of the World Bank, and where a young farmer dreaming to set up a food processing unit can listen to the views of UN Secretary General on issues like food security. That is why during one of the previous events, I had called it Davos in Action. Friends, India has always believed that the whole world is one family. Vasudhaiv Kutumbakam. Few have seen this in practice. I am informed that more than 100 countries are participating in this event. 100 से अधिक देश एक छत के नीचे आज इकट्ठे हुए हैं. We are here as a family, not only in terms of space, but also because we recognize that someone's dream, it depends on someone's direction. Someone's success is related to someone's support. Someone's curiosity is linked to someone's care. This is what a family does. The ultimate objective is welfare of all. हमारे यहां कहा गया है लोका समस्त सुखी न भवतु. I'm sure all of us, from the Secretary General of UN to the President of the World Bank, from the leaders of the strongest economies to the delegations of the small countries, from CEOs of Fortune 500 companies to startup entrepreneurs, all want to the planet Earth become a better place to live. Thus, our meeting here is not just a meeting of hands, but also of hearts. It is not only a meeting of ideas, but also of aspirations. As a host, this family gathering, as a curator of thousands of dreaming floating here, I welcome you all once again. I hope your stay here is, of course, comfortable. वैसे भी गुजराती लोग मेहमान नवाजी में जरा अच्छे हो रहते हैं. I trust you will enjoy our hospitality. This is a time of kite festival in Gujarat. This festival gives us the message of high spirits. Do participate in it. Friends, after becoming Prime Minister, I have traveled to the remotest part of the India and also to various parts of the world. I have been to the UN, BRICS, ASEAN Summit, G20, SAARC Summits. Some common worries have been expressed everywhere. The biggest concern is about the global economy. We all have to find the ways for stability and recovery. We also have to work for sustainable and inclusive growth. We in India believe that problems present us with opportunities. To become stronger, disciplined and innovative. My government is trying to generate confidence. We have prepared a team to secure a robust future. We believe that changes start with a change in mindset. Friends, it is a matter of great pleasure that today there is a tremendous interest in India. और मैंने देखा है दुनिया में जहां गया जिसे मिला चारों तरफ भारत के प्रति रुचि भारत के प्रति आकर्षण भारत के प्रति गौरव का भाव ये मैं अनुभव कर रहा हूं और मैं मानता हूं कि ये अपने आप में ये हमारी बहुत बड़ी ताकत है. Countries are coming forward to work with us. This has, of course, generated expectations from India. India's present as well as its rich past is being recognized. I thank the UN Secretary General for giving a formal international stature to yoga. A record number of 177 countries supported the Indian proposal. Yoga is both a science and an art. For improving human life, in today's world, it teaches us to remain stable even in adverse situations. Friends, the 2009 edition of this event created vibrancy when the state of the global economy was depressing. The summits of 2008 2011 and 2013 succeeded in strengthening investors' confidence. It is only because of persistence with positivity that this event of Gujarat government has become an event for the entire country. This platform has been enlarged so that other states too can take advantage. Today, many other states have adopted this approach. और मैंने पिछले दिनों देखा, मध्य प्रदेश हो, पश्चिम बंगाल हो, सभी देश राज्य अपने अपने तरीके से एक सकारात्मक भूमिका निभाते हुए प्रयास कर रहे हैं. The government of India is committed to support such initiatives by any state government. Friends, we will have to change the way we have been approaching problems. Recession is often seen just in the consolation leaves. Have we ever thought of its solution in terms of enhancing the common man's employability, income and purchasing power? This is the biggest task at hand in India. Mahatma Gandhi rightly talked about the last man. वो दरिद्र नारायण की बात करते थे. And Gandhiji's message can show us the way. It is therefore appropriate that this summit is taking place in Mahatma Mandir, an excellent multimedia exhibition on the life of the Mahatma has been set up in Dandi Kutir. It's very hardly 3 minutes walk. It portrays the life journey of Gandhiji in brief. In addition, just a few steps away from the venue, there is a world-class mega exhibition which showcases products and service by leading companies from India and abroad. और मैं आप सबसे आग्रह करूंगा कि कितनी ही व्यस्तता क्यों न हो, लेकिन इसी कैंपस में दांडी कुटीर में मल्टीमीडिया टेक्नोलॉजी का उपयोग करते हुए महात्मा गांधी का जो प्रदर्शनी बनाई है, आप उसे जरूर देखिए. और पास में ही इतना बड़ा एग्जीबिशन शायद हमारे देश में कभी होता नहीं है. एक प्रकार का यूनिक ट्रेड फेयर है. मैं चाहूंगा कि आप जरूर उसकी मुलाकात लें. I'm sure you will not miss the chance to see these magnificent exhibitions. To me, the best outcome of this event should be inclusiveness and involvement of communities, needing care and development. Thus, this event stands for inclusiveness of small with big, inclusiveness of poor with rich, inclusiveness of gut feelings with mature thoughts. I assure this global platform that India wants to work with the global leadership, be the issues of poverty or ecology. We want to contribute to welfare of the global community. We are aware that with 1/6 of the world's population, our activities will have a global impact. We are ready to learn and make this impact positive. However, India has to be seen from a different angle. It is not just a country of today. It is also an old civilization. It is not just a country of a few cities. It is a country of thousands of towns and several hundred thousands villages. It is a country of diverse communities. Therefore, India has its own solution for many pressing problems. Our philosophy is a philosophy of conservation. Our culture teaches us nurturing of nature. Our way of life is that of harnessing. Such thoughts and practices have excited in India for centuries. Thus, whatever we will do, it will be aligned with our culture, ethos and beliefs. Because we know this is what will work in India. Friends, our last national elections mark a turning point in Indian democracy. They indicated the high aspirations of our people. This was amply reflected in the record voter participation and a clear verdict in favor of one political party after a gap of 30 years. My government is committed to changing and improving the economic and social conditions of India, including the quality of life. In a short span of 7 months, we have been able to change the atmosphere of despair and uncertainty. Since the first day, my government is actively working to revive the economy. My government is committed to create a policy environment that is predictable, transparent and fair. Friends, we are on the path of transformation. To start this process, we are making efforts to change the work culture. We have to strengthen our institutions and systems of delivery. To drive this change forcefully, we have recently reconstituted our planning commission. Now it is known as Niti Aayog. We want to promote cooperative federalism. We want to promote cooperative federalism in the country. At the same time, we want a competitive element among the states to create and attract whatever is needed there. I call this new form of federalism cooperative and competitive federalism. You may be aware that our economic growth and slowdown during the last few years. Now, my government is putting in efforts to ensure faster and yet inclusive growth. The initial results are encouraging. On the economic front, during the first two quarters, we registered a growth rate which was 1% higher than the previous year. The IMF has observed that India will be the second fastest growing economy in the coming years. According to the latest forecast of OECD, India would be the only country among the world's top economies which would increase its pace of growth this year. The HSBC's latest report has identified India as the world's largest growing exporter, which is set to move from being the 14th to the 5th largest exporter in the world by 2030. On the political front also, people of various states have supported us in the recent assembly elections. This gives us the confidence that we are moving on the right direction. Let me tell you a little about what we are doing and where we want to reach. Friends, we are not merely making commitments and announcements. We are also backing them up with concrete action at the level of policy and practice. For example, I announced a financial inclusion program. In 4 months, we have opened more than 100 million bank accounts. एक प्रकार से 100 दिन में 10 करोड़ से ज्यादा प्रधानमंत्री जनधन योजना के खाते खुलना सिर्फ घोषणा नहीं, उसको साकार करने में सफलता तक पाना और निर्धारित समय में पाना. वी आर प्लानिंग टू बिल्ड स्मार्ट सिटीज इक्विप्ड विथ वर्ल्ड क्लास एमिनिटीज. फॉर दिस पर्पज we have further liberalized the FDI policy in construction sector. I announced that a modern rail system, including high speed rails, will be set up. Immediately we opened up railways for 100% foreign direct investment. I announced that defense production in the country would be encouraged. The next step was to open the defense sector for foreign direct investment up to 49%. We have taken similar steps in many other areas. These include bringing 49% FDI in insurance. It also includes liberalization of FDI norms for manufacturing of medical devices. Simultaneously, on the administrative front, we are actively working to provide policy-driven governance. और मैं इस बात का बहुत आग्रही रहा हूं कि राज्य हो, सरकार हो, वो policy-driven होनी चाहिए. Individual के whims पर नहीं चलनी चाहिए. और हमने केंद्र सरकार को भी उस दिशा में बहुत आग्रहपूर्वक बढ़ाने की दिशा में सफलता से कदम उठाए हैं. वी हैव टेकन फार रीचिंग डिसीजन टू एंश्योर सप्लाई ऑफ की नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज. दिस इंक्लूड्स कोल, आयरन ओर एंड अदर मिनरल्स. वी ऑल्सो अमेंडेड legal provisions to facilitate availability of land. This has been done to enable development in remote areas while ensuring better returning to the farming community. We are trying to complete the circle of economic reform speedily. We are also keen to see that our policies are predictable. We are clear that our tax regime should be stable. In the last few months, we have taken several decisions in this direction. We have put focus on building infrastructure through public and private investments. This will include national roads national grids for gas, electricity and water grid. It also includes rural infrastructure, 24/7 electric supply, farm irrigation and cleaning up and connecting of rivers. In order to execute the infrastructure plan, a fast track PPP mechanism is being put in place. We are undertaking the Sagarmala project to ensure port-led development. Existing ports are being modernized. New world-class ports will be developed along India's coastal circle. Ports will be better connected to the hinterland through road and rail. Inland and coastal waterways will be developed as major transport routes. Low-cost airports are being planned to improve regional connectivity, especially to Tier 2 towns and places of economic and tourist importance. We are also keen to move towards the next generation infrastructure. Just as we need highways, we need highways too. When I say highways, information ways. Under the Digital India Initiative, IT will be used to drive government process to improve service delivery and program implementation and also to provide broadband connectivity to the villages. To upgrade manufacturing infrastructure, we are setting up a world-class investment and industrial regions along the dedicated freight corridor and industrial corridors. Government of India is working towards single window clearance at the federal and state levels. 4 months back, we launched Make in India initiative to encourage the growth of manufacturing in the country. We are working hard to make India a global manufacturing hub. We are promoting, in particular, लेबर इंटेंसिव मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, क्योंकि मेरे देश में बहुत बड़ी मात्रा में युवा है और रोजगार हमारी प्राथमिकता है और इसलिए हम लेबर इंटेंसिव प्रोजेक्ट को अधिक से अधिक बल देना चाहते हैं. आई हैव लॉन्च दिस इनिशिएटिव्स इन ए कैंपेन मोड सो दैट they force us in the government to make faster corrections. Kabhi kabhi logon ko lagta hai ki Modi har cheez ko hype par kyon le jate hain, lekin ye hype sarkar ko bhi daudne ke liye majboor karti hai, apne aap ko theek karne ke liye majboor karti hai. Ye momentum apne aap mein khud ko bhi parivartan lane ke liye प्रेरित करता है. द चैलेंज इज अस टू डू अवे विद द रेड टैप एंड बिकम प्रोएक्टिव. विद दिस पर्पज आवर एप्लीकेशंस एंड प्रोसेसेस आर बीइंग एग्रेसिवली पुट ऑनलाइन. ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस इन इंडिया इज ए प्राइम कंसर्न फॉर यू एंड अस. और मुझे याद है वर्ल्ड बैंक के चेयरमैन पिछली बार जब भारत आए थे उन्होंने एक प्रेस स्टेटमेंट दिया था. उन्होंने कहा था कि ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस में अगर हिंदुस्तान आगे बढ़ता है तो आज उसका नंबर 150 के भी पीछे है वो देखते ही देखते पहले 50 में आ जाएगा. वर्ल्ड बैंक चेयरमैन ने जो प्रिडिक्ट किया था, मैं विश्वास से कहता हूं कि हमने ईज ऑफ बिजनेस का जो इनिशिएटिव लिया है एक के बाद एक जो कदम उठा रहे हैं, हम उस गोल को भी अचीव करने में शायद देर नहीं लगेगी। आई एश्योर यू दैट वी आर वर्किंग वेरी सीरियसली ऑन दिस इश्यूज। वी वॉन्ट टू मेक दैट नॉट ओनली ईजियर देन अर्लियर, नॉट ओनली ईजियर देन द रेस्ट, बट वी वॉन्ट टू मेक दैम easiest. Friends, many of you might be interested to know why India. आखिरकार क्यों लोग यहां पूंजी लगाएंगे? और यही सवाल का जवाब उनको भारत में निवेश करने के लिए, भारत में अपना नसीब आजमाने के लिए एक प्रेरणा भी देता है, ताकत भी देता है और एक नया विश्वास भी देता है। वाई इंडिया? इंडिया इज द थ्री थिंग्स टू इट्स क्रेडिट: डेमोक्रेसी, डेमोग्राफी एंड डिमांड। दिस इज व्हाट यू आर लुकिंग फॉर एंड आई एम श्योर यू विल नॉट फाइंड ऑल ऑफ देम टुगेदर एट एनी अदर डेस्टिनेशन इन द वर्ल्ड। India offers you the potential of low-cost manufacturing. India has low-cost and high-quality manpower. 65% of our population is below 35 years of age. We are trying to further harness this strength through better management and good governance and skill development mission. In the recently launched Mars Orbiter mission, everything was made indigenously. In fact, most mission components were made in very small factories. और हमने जो मंगलयान में सफलता प्राप्त की है उसका जो खर्चा हुआ है, हॉलीवुड की मूवी से भी कम खर्चे में हम मंगल पर पहुंचे हैं और पहले प्रयास में पहुंचे हैं। इतना ही नहीं, अहमदाबाद में ऑटो रिक्शा में अगर आप जाएं और एक किलोमीटर जाना है तो कम से कम 10 रुपया किराया लगता होगा। हम मंगलयान मंगल तक पहुंचे हैं सिर्फ 7 रुपये किलोमीटर के खर्चे से। Friends, we have large number of hands to work and we have even larger number of dreams to be realized. Therefore, employment opportunities are being enhanced by promoting manufacturing, agro-based industries, tourism as well as service sector. We have undertaken labor reforms to encourage enterprise and to create a bigger job market for our youth. I have always said that development process should benefit the common man as well as the business sector. Therefore, my government has established a new ministry for skill development to enhance our human resource potential. For this, we are placing equal emphasis on knowledge, technology, innovation, and research and development. This includes the use of ICT for improving governance and resource management. I understand, because I use modern tools of communication myself, and people are very familiar with my social media activity. Friends, today India is a land of opportunities. We have to build fast track roads and railways. We have to energize homes and factories on a continuous basis. We have to build infrastructure for cities wherever almost half of our population live. We have to take the test of modern amenities to our rural area, to our every village. We have to propel our growth through value addition in our natural resources and agri produces. We have to provide service to our people which are of global standards. At the same time, the whole world is looking for certain services. If our human resources can be equipped with skills and technology, we may serve the world in many areas. Thus, there are immense possibilities for global investors in India. The process of development we are talking of is not incremental. We are planning to take a quantum leap. It is not limited to one sector or region. It is truly unlimited. And we want to do things in a cleaner and greener way. We are open to ideas, investments and innovations. Friends, we have made commitments to our people. We have made commitments to ourselves. We have made commitments for India's great future. We have to write our new destiny. And we have to write in the very short time. We know that to do this, we need an enabling policy framework. We are working constantly to improve it further. However, I can say with confidence that even today, the strength of Indian democracy and independence of judicial system provide a level playing field for long-lasting business. I would conclude by saying that we are dreaming big, and our dreams are numerous. Our dreams can become the seeds of your growth. Our aspirations can propel your ambitions. Friends, on behalf of the government, let me give an assurance. We assure you that we will be available to hold your hands whenever you need us. You will find us standing with you in your journey. If you walk one step, we will walk two steps for you. At the end, I urge you to see and realize for yourself that India is changing fast. India is growing fast. India is moving faster than expected. India is learning even faster. India is ready than ever before. Let us join hands. Let us work together for progress, prosperity and peace. मुझे विश्वास है कि गुजरात का ये प्रयास, मैं गुजरात सरकार को, आदरणीय मुख्यमंत्री जी को बधाई देता हूं कि अब तक जितने वाइब्रेंट समिट हुए हैं उससे ज्यादा ताकतवर, ज्यादा ऊंचाई वाला और न सिर्फ गुजरात को, पूरे देश को एक नया विश्वास जगाने वाला महात्मा मंदिर की धरती पर हुआ ये समागम देश की युवा पीढ़ी को नया विश्वास देगा, देश को विकास की नई ऊंचाइयों पर पहुंचने के लिए एक रास्ता दिखाएगा। और इस बात के लिए मैं गुजरात की जनता का, गुजरात सरकार का हृदय से अभिनंदन करता हूं। अर्बन डेवलपमेंट मिनिस्टर वेंकैया जी को जितनी जानकारी हैदराबाद की है, जितनी जानकारी विशाखापट्टनम की है,